Hello everybody, I hope all of you all are doing well. I am Sakshi Hemant and I am here to brief you all about footprint and footwear analysis. Well, first and foremost, what is footprint and footwear impression? The marks made by a person's feet is footprint impression, whereas the marks made by the sole of the footwear is a footwear impression. 80% of cases encounter foot or footwear impression, and these are the potential evidence of presence of perpetrators in the crime scene. Foot impression have more evidentiary value than footwear impression. Even the monozygotic twins can be identified using footprints. Forensic podiatry is the study of foot and footwear impression as an evidence. Let's talk about the significance of footprints. The analysis of the impression involves studying the class and individual characteristics. The class characteristics include the size, sole pattern, manufacturer's logo, design, etc., whereas the individual characteristics include the numerous creases, wear and tear patterns, flat foot characteristics, deformities, etc. Flat foot is a condition found in 1.54% of the population, where complete instep region of plantar surface of the foot is impressed on the surface. These people are not recruited into military and police forces as they are not considered to have high standards of physical fitness. In 2008, a Gujarati ex-serviceman helped the army to track the intruders with the footprints as the key evidence. The depth of the footprints on the soft materials helps us to determine the approximate weight of the suspect. Sometimes, the sex of the individual is also known. There are three types of impressions found: latent, patent, and plastic print. Latent prints are unseen to the naked eye and they have to be developed using powder or chemical methods. Patent prints are visible due to transfer of colored substances like blood. TMB, amido black, or any color-changing reagents are used to enhance and clearly visualize the print. Plastic prints are formed on soft surfaces which are pliable enough to take the print. For example, prints on snow. Let's now get to the collection methods. Photography is a very important method of recording the crime scene and the evidence. Once that is done, depending on the type of impression, adhesive lifters, gelatin lifters, ESDL, that is electrostatic dust lifting device, and casting is done to lift the foot impression. These impressions are then used for examination. Analysis or examination of footprints helps to identify the individual and the places that he has walked during the commission of the crime. Comparison of the collected samples from the crime scene and the test impressions obtained from the suspect will be conducted. The test impression to be compared should be obtained in similar conditions as that of the collected sample from the crime scene. Physical measurements and examination of class and individual characteristics will be performed. Examination of dimensions, which include the length, breadth, width, and other relevant measurements. Repair mark analysis like nail patterns, stitch marks, and additional patch of sole in the footwear should be looked into. We have to examine and see the presence of any foreign material in the impression. The shape, outline, design, and position of the footwear are examined. All the above examination requires tools such as dividers, calipers, DSLR cameras, ABFO scales, special lighting, and necessary casting materials. The FBI's Criminal Justice Information System maintains the footwear database. I hereby conclude the briefing with a small case study that took place in Florida. A murder was committed and investigators were called to examine the scene. A bloody shoe print was found on the carpet in the home of the murder victim. The print indicated that there was a hole in the shoe that left the print. Investigators collected and made test prints of the shoes from individuals known to be at the scene near the time of the murder. Footwear examiners were able to identify the perpetrators by overlaying the bloody shoe print from the crime scene with the test print made from the suspect's shoe. And this is how they caught hold of the criminal. I hope you got a basic idea about footprint, footwear, and its analysis. Thank you so much for watching. Take care and stay safe.